Let's go ahead and get started. What we're going to have is a meeting of the Juvie Crossing Community Development District. We got a couple council meeting members coming up. Make sure we get a quorum here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We're good now. 7. All right. Here they come. This meeting today being February 22nd, 5:45 p.m. in the Livingston Parish Council Chambers. This is a call to order for the Juvie Crossing Community Development District, Livingston Parish, State of Louisiana. Ms. Sandy, you want to call the roll and make sure we have a quorum here?
Sir. Mr. Coates. Mr. Shavers. Mr. Taylor.
Here.
Ms. Sandifer. Mr. Erdy.
Here.
Mr. Goff.
Here.
Mr. Watts.
Here.
Mr. Mangus.
Here.
Mr. Wascom.
Here. All right, Mr. Ryan's just walking in for the record, by the way, so we're good. That's okay. This is a consideration and approval. This will be a resolution of the Juvie Crossing Community Development District, Parish of Livingston, State of Louisiana, to adopt the operating budget for revenues and expenditures for the calendar year of 2024. Juvie Crossing was just a pasture some years back, and through the process of the City of Denham Springs and Livingston Parish and the hard work of Mr. Scott Crawford, Juvie Crossing has turned into one of the biggest economic engines of this parish. So with any revenues that are being made from that, it's going right back into infrastructure. It won't be long before Cook Road Extension will be complete, tying Juvie Crossing into the Pete's Highway, Denham Springs. Mr. Crawford, you want to come to the podium and answer any questions if anyone has anything? If I'm not mistaken, the budget's resolutions attached, and I think we've had copies of the budget already. It's not a bunch of money there, but it's all put back in infrastructure. Mr. Crawford, do you have any?
Correct, Mr. Chairman. Thank you, lady and members of the council. My name is Scott Crawford. I represent the developer at Juvie Crossing. As the chairman said, back in 2000, we were a lot of wetlands and scrub trees and some nice trees out there, but it was, you know, basically very rural. We had no infrastructure at all. And Mr. Chairman, after 20 years, we're an overnight success. We have over $1.5 million of retail square footage that's open and operating and flourishing. We have over 500 employees full-time and about 400 part-time. And we have invested out there about $150 million. And we have a taxing district that generates money for the infrastructure improvements, which didn't exist out there. It's a tax on ourselves, on the property that we have on premises. That's the CDD budget we're passing tonight, and then also the EDD budget, which is a sales tax on revenues we generate inside the shopping center. And we greatly appreciate the support of the council over the years, and the City of Denham Springs has been very helpful. We use their sewer system. They overbuilt a little bit, anticipating that we were going to make a deal with them, and they were right. And we're doing relatively well right now. But this is a small tax on an apartment project out there that's really the only residential we have right now. We net out about $23,000 a year, and it all goes back, as the chairman said, into the infrastructure of the project.
So whereas the district is required annually to adopt an annual budget, and whereas the desire of the district to adopt the budget attached in Exhibit A, I believe we have. So basically what's needed is a resolution by the Council of Livingston Parish acting as the governing authority of that community development district, hereby adopted in its entirety as required the annual budget. The resolution shall take effect immediately upon its adoption, and any provisions and previous resolutions in conflict with the provision hereof are hereby suspended. This resolution shall be published and required in the official journal of the district. Is there a motion to adopt this resolution, or is there any questions? All right, let's go ahead and hear from our parish president, and then we'll save the council or the district.
Keep in mind, we for this tax break, I don't know legally we can. I just talked to the attorney. The governor signed an executive order today that formed a new taxing district for each parish, each one of the 64 parishes. I think Ms. Sandy's also has a copy of that. Ms. Sandy, do you? Executive order signed today?
No, sir.
Okay. Well, we want this to go forward. So maybe you can adopt it contingent on the governor's.
If there's something that we need to undo or redo, we'll be glad to. But Mr. Mangus, you have a question?
I was going to make the motion, move the motion.
A motion by Mr. Mangus to approve the budget for the Cuban Community Development District. Is there a second?
Yeah.
Second by Mr. Lonnie Watts. Any more discussion? Ms. Sandy, you want to call for the vote, please?
Mr. Coates?
Yes.
Mr. Shavers?
Yes.
Mr. Taylor?
Yes.
Ms. Sandifer?
Yes.
Mr. Erty?
Yes.
Mr. Goff?
Yes.
Mr. Watts?
Yes.
Mr. Mangus?
Yes.
Mr. Wascom?
Yes. Is nothing else on the agenda, Mr. Crawford? Is there a motion? Ricky, did you have a question?
I just want to make sure we're clear with Mr. Randy on. I'm not sure what the executive order. Are you familiar with what took place today?
And no, sir. That's
I want to make sure that we are passing what we need to pass correctly.
I would pass a contingent on the governor's executive order today. Each one of the 64 parishes, he formed the industrial board and sent a morning advocate. We all got emails on this. So I would just say contingents on that board. The new board formed is the sheriff, the parish president, and the school board president. And if it's inside a municipality like Denver Springs, then the mayor is also on that board.
All right. Well, you want to make that part of the motion contingent upon the...
We have no problem with that.
You okay with that, Scott?
Sure.
I mean, I would imagine that he did that for the reason of creating districts.
That's correct.
But this is already created. We're just adopting the budget, I would think.
This district and the other district, our EDD district, was created by this council in 2007. There are two ways to create an economic development district. And one of those ways is by state act, and the other is by parish or municipal act. So we came to the parish, and that's how we got it formed.
Yeah, how I would read that is that when the governor's executive order takes place, because it wasn't vetoed or anything, you would roll into that. You would be part of that, right? Because the two ways to create it.
Take advantage of it, but I don't think that. I think the intended purpose was for industrial development, and this is more retail and residential.
So
it would be separate entities, and if they're separate entities, I don't know if we want to put them on the same.
It wouldn't supersede these two entities you've created.
I think because this has been existing, etc. I just want to make sure I was clear because I didn't know what the executive order was.
Leave it like it is. Okay, that's fine. Any more discussion? None being, is there a motion to adjourn?
I'll make that motion.
Motion by Mr. Taylor, second by Mr. Watts. Any more discussion? All in favor say yes.
Yes.
Is there any opposed? That motion carries. I declare this voting adjourned.